Assalamu alaikum, dear students. So today we will solve a practical question on the yield to maturity concept. Hope you will understand my last lecture about the yield to maturity. So today this is the question that I have solved to clarify your concept about the YTM. The face value of the bond is 1000. Redeemable after 4 years means that their maturity is 4 years. So after 4 years, the company will redeem it, call back it at the rate 1200. Coupon rate is our interest rate, that is also called coupon rate, is 8%. Determine YTM if the present market price of the bond is 1050. So look it, there are two approaches to find out the YTM. One approach is by trial and error method. We can calculate the rate of the returns approximately. And second one method is through by formula. We can solve this question. So this is also the formula, that YTM is equals to LDR plus IV at LDR minus MP divided by IV at LDR minus IV at HDR multiplied by HDR minus LDR. What is what does it mean by where I will write this like LDR, that is equals to, yeah, abbreviated as a low discount rate, low where HDR is equals to high discount rate, higher IV is equals to intrinsic value. Intrinsic value. So the more concise method is trial and error based method. First I will solve this question on the trial and error based method. If we looked out the question, so bond is offering 8% interest, and similarly the redemption price is also high. This is the coupon which is offered by bond, that is 8%. 8% coupon that is offered by the bond. And similarly the redemption price. Redemption price is what? 1200. Look it, redemption after 4 years means after 4 years when their maturity is completed. So this will be call back. Redemption means call back by the business. You know, the 1000 face value barn will purchase bake. Call bake 8 1200. So look it, 8% we will get four, up to 4 year we will get the returns 8%. And look at this 8%, that will be apply on the face value. Look the interest rate, how to calculate the interest. So interest should not be calculated on the redemption price. Interest will be calculated, your coupon rate will be calculated on the face value of the bond. So $80 for the 4 year we will receive, and at the 4th year when its maturity is completed at the end, so we will also receive the $1200. And if we looked out the current market price, that is 1050. The face value is 1000 and market price is 1050. It means that the bond market price is more than the face value, $50. This is called premium price. It means that the bond is trading in the market on premium price. So we will start with the higher rate than 8%. Determining the intrinsic value of the bond using the desired rate of return, let's suppose more than 8%. Why? On 8% that is given. So we will start more than from 8%, like 9%, 10%, 11%, 12%, and then we will check out in trial and error based method that let's suppose we apply the 9%, 9% intrinsic value is too much more greater than this current market price 150. So then we will again increase the rate to 10%, and if again on 10%, the value, the intrinsic value that was not near to 1050, so further we will increase the discount rate to bring down the value, the intrinsic value, near to the current market price, that is 1050. So it, we can say that there is an inverse relationship between the discount rate and the intrinsic value. When we want to decrease the intrinsic value, so we should increase the discount rate. Now for this purpose, I will show this one. Like here, I solved this question for you people to clarify your look it. I take the discount rate 10%. So this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 year bonds whose maturity is 4 year. Cash flows at zero time, let's suppose today I purchase it. So minus 1000, current market price is how much? That is 1050. This is current market price. This price, in today, this is trading on 1050. After 1 year, I will receive the $80 interest. After second year, I will receive further $80. Then I will receive $80, and then when that is completed, so $1200 plus $80. So now, if we looked out, so this $80, $80, and $1200 we will receive after 4 years. At which, let's suppose the discount rate is 10%. So for the discount rate, we are using the discounting formula. And we need, these are the future expected returns. These are 80, 80, 80, 1280. This we will receive in future, but we are calculating its value, present value. So how we will use the formula that present value is equals to future value divided by 1 plus I raised to the power n. We are using that formula. So according to that, we finding out the discounting factor. So today we make investment. So here no discounting, no time value of money concept here. So zero time. After one year, so 10% will be equals to 1 divided by this value that is come from where? That I divided 1 divided by 1 plus 10%. One divided by 1 plus 10% raised to the power n. So look at, dear students, at first year 1 divided by 1 plus 10% raised to the power 1. Instead of one, n, we will write n. At second year, 1 divided by 1 plus 10% raised to the power 2, and so on. So in this way, you will finding out the discount rates. Now, when I discounting rate, so when I sum it, so the sum of the total discounting factor value is 3.1698. Now look at 1 to 2 year. Sorry, here I make some mistake. 1 to 4. It means that we will receive $80. So I apply the discounting factor here, present value factors, and that is 10%. As that was 3.1698. This 80 multiplied by 3.169, that is equals to 253.58. Look at, if we received 80, so that will be equals to 320. But when we apply 10% discount, that is equals to 253.58. Similarly, at fourth year, we also received the 1200. So the 1200, 1 divided by 1 plus 10 raised to the power 4, that is equals to 0.6830. That is the discounting rate. So 1200 multiplied by that discount rate is equals to 1200 will be equals to the discounting value 819.62. So this is, we calculate the discounting value, that is equals to 1073.20. This 1073.20, this is called the intrinsic value. Now we will compare the intrinsic value, this value, with the market value. And here our market value, if we looked out, so our market value is $1050. And here the intrinsic value, that is 1073. So intrinsic value is more than the current market price. It means that, or we can say that market price is less than the intrinsic value. So what we should do? We will try that to decrease this intrinsic value. Up to how? Near to this market price, 1050. So that the when the market price of the bond is lower than the intrinsic value of the bond, so what we will do? We will increase the discount rate, because what there is inverse relationship between the intrinsic value and the discounting rate. When we are increasing the discount rate, so negatively effect will take place on the intrinsic value.
Now I increase the discount rate from 10 to 11. So just like in the same formula, we 1 divided by 1 plus I raised to the power n, we finding out the discount rates. Here we finding out the discount rate. So on 11%, when 11% is applied, so 11% discounting factor sum is 3.1025. So 3.10, this one, this discounting factor multiplied by 80, so that is equals to 248.30. And this one is 1200 multiplied by their discount rate, so that is equal to 790. And now the intrinsic value is 1038. So this 1038 is my intrinsic value. Now this intrinsic value, if we compare with the market price, so market price is 1050. Now intrinsic value is 1038. So intrinsic value in this case is less than the market price. So intrinsic value in this case, in the second case, is less than the market price, i.e. 1038 is less than 1050. So the market price of the bond is, we know that, dear students, that is 1050. Is higher than the intrinsic value. So it means that our required ATM is now, we are between 10, that is between the 10% and 11%. That is between the 10% and 11%. How? Because look at the intrinsic value, that is 1050. So in one case, 1073 and 1038. At 10%, 1073, and at 11%, that is 1038. So when it shows that to us that our value, intrinsic value, that is what, that is between our 10% and 11%. Now what we will do, look at, dear students, from this we reach to a point that our value is between 10% and 11%. How? Look at here, I draw this one, that if the value is 10% and so my intrinsic value is 1073, when I increase the discount rate from 10 to 11%, so now intrinsic value decreased to 1038. But look at this, 1000 is 50, that is between here, between the 10 and 11%. Now what we will do, we are saying that when we change from 10 to 11%, so 1% change. So how much change taken place in the value, in the intrinsic value? 1073 minus 1038. So that is equals to 34.53, that is the change. It means that when we are bring changes here, look at 1% bring change. So 1% change leads to us 34.53 value. And what is the difference between this intrinsic value 1000 and this market price 1050? That is how much 23 we need to reduce 23.20. So here how much percentage change we bring, that is unknown. X I take is at a X in a locate. When we bring 1% change, so there is a change 34.53 change comes in the value. Now we need 23.20 change. Why? Because 1073.20 minus this 1050 market price, that is equal to 23.20. So how much percentage change we bring, that is unknown. So by cross multiplication zarabain or wasatain, you are saying by cross multiplication. So X multiplied by 34.53 is equals to 1% multiplied by 23.20. By rearranging, X is equals to both hand side will be divided by 34.53. So X is equals to 0.0067. It means that 0.67, that is X value we finding out. This will be, if we convert it to percentage form, so that is equals to 0.0067. Clear? Now, look at what is OITM. From 10% we start. We can say that at 10%, that is 73.1. So 10% plus how much? 0.67%. So 10% plus we put the value of X. So that is equals to 10.67. So 10.67 is now my YTM. And this is that rate which equalize the current market price, this current market price, with the discounting price of this one, the $80, $80 discounting dollar, $80 plus $80 plus $80 plus $80 plus $1200. The discounting of that will be equals to 1050. Which rate? That is the rate 10.67. So 10.67 is now our YTM. Hope you will understand this. Now, if we put in the formula, so like what is the here in the formula, low discount rate. I will go to back to the here to the slide. What is my low discount rate? High discount rate is 11%. Low discount rate is 10%. So 10% plus intrinsic value at low discount rate. At 10%, what was the intrinsic value? 1073 minus market price 150 divided by intrinsic value at low discount rate. Intrinsic value at low discount rate here means 10% is our low discount rate. So 1073 point something minus intrinsic value at high discount rate at 11% discount value was 1038 point something multiplied by HDR high discount rate 11% minus low discount rate 10%. So when we solve it, the same answer will be, they will give us 10.67. So this, according to the formula, you can put the value. That is your homework. This one is your homework. Answer will be the same. That will answer will be 10.67 approximately. That is also called approx. So this was the concept of the
yield to maturity concept. Hope you will understand. So for now, I will leave the class, and inshallah we'll meet you in the upcoming class. So have a good time, have a good Ramzan. Keep me in your prayers. Allah Hafiz.